Launching trucks and hauling freight. Hey! 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 Red and green and brown and blue, they're the really useful crew. Down the hills and round the bends, Thomas and his friends.
Thomas was puffing happily along with his coaches, Annie and Clarabelle. It was a breezy kind of day. Thomas arrived at Napfruit. The fat controller was waiting.
I need you to drop some logs off at the lumber mill, Thomas. Another engine will take the afternoon train.
Yes, sir.
Meanwhile, at the lumber mill...
Remind me why we're here and not scrapping. Come on, Harry. Even if we need wood for sleepers now and then.
Hey, did you hear that whistle?
Yeah. Don't sound familiar to me, though.
Hello, I'm Neville. Just collecting some pieces for the harbor yard.
Ah, another steam puffer.
Oh. Bothered. Neville became nervous and bumped too hard into his wagons.
Watch where you going, stupid.
Oh, that must be the new engine. He's friends with the scrap diesels? Must be a terrible kind of engine.
Later, Thomas met some of the other engines and told them about what he had seen.
What's he called? Neville?
Something like that.
What are the odds? He even has the word evil right in the middle of his name.
I guess. But more important than that, he was laughing with them.
Neville's a disgrace. Talking to diesels is one thing, but being friends with Ari and Bert, well, it's disillusioning.
Ari and Bert are the cruelest of diesels on this railway, or any I've ever heard of.
That's not what I was going to say. But excellent point, nonetheless.
We must avoid him as much as possible. Show him there are consequences for such behavior.
All right, then. I'm off to help mend the broken bridge.
Neville arrived at the harbor with his lumber.
Hello! I've brought the order of lumber. You can just leave it there. We'll pick it up later.
All right. Say, I didn't get your name.
Oh.
Later, Neville had to take a passenger train. He saw Percy in the yard.
Hello. Where might I find some coaches? I have a train to pull.
They're over there somewhere. Engines aren't very friendly on this railway. Neville finally found the coach yard. Annie and Clarabelle were the first ones he saw.
Neville was unhappy.
Edward stopped at the platform.
Hello there. Are you Neville?
Yes. You're the first engine to speak to me today. What's your name?
Edward, is something the matter?
I don't know. The other engines have been avoiding me all day. The first two I met were very rude. They aren't like the diesels on my old railway.
I'm sorry to hear that. Our engines are rather friendly, most of the time. You'll fit in soon.
I hope so.
Neville raced through the countryside. As he passed through Marin, the station master shouted,
"Runaway train!"
A runaway goods train had rolled down Gordon's Hill and crossed over onto Neville's line. Neville ran as fast as he could.
"We've got to stop those trucks. They're heading for trouble."
Neville let the train catch up behind them. Annie and Clairvaux shrieked as the wagons approached.
At last, got him!
But there was worse to come. Neville was headed for the broken bridge.
Look out!
Neville crashed through the barrier. Neville was hanging dangerously over the edge of the broken bridge. Thomas had seen everything.
Thomas, help us, please!
Cinders and ashes! Thomas puffed very slowly and carefully. He buffered up behind Neville's train and pulled as gently as he could. At last, Neville and the coaches were safe.
Thank you! I was so scared! Are you all right?
I think so. It's been quite a day, if I'm honest.
I see that. I'm just glad my coaches are all right.
Neville is a hero! He stopped this runaway train, and us, from falling off the edge of the bridge!
Seems like you're quite the hero, Neville. My name is Thomas.
That evening, the engines had all heard about Neville's bravery.
What a splendid engine! I'm sorry my trucks caused you so much trouble.
Indeed, it's fortunate for us to have such an engine of character come and join our yard.
You're welcome any time!
And just like that, Neville became part of the railway family.